Now, most of us take talking for granted. Some of us do too much of it, you might argue. But can you imagine the frustration of knowing what you want to say but not being able to get your words out properly because of uncontrollable stammering? Well, today the government has announced it's giving more funding to speech therapy programs to help children who stammer. Aisling McVeigh has been to see how it works at a clinic in London.
Evan O'Brien is seven and is being treated for a stammer at the Michael Palin Centre for Stammering Children.
You were having a bit of trouble with your talking before, weren't
yes.
you?
Yes.
What was happening?
I don't know really how to explain it. But bumpy speaking means you're stopping in the middle of a sentence.
And when you've got something you really want to say, how does that make you feel when it's bumpy?
Quite annoyed.
I found it really, really hard to deal with watching your own child find it difficult to speak, and it was worrying. I didn't know anything about stammering at the time, so I wasn't sure whether it was curable.
5% of children under 5 will stammer at some point, but most grow out of it, leaving around 1% of the adult population stammering, and men are more affected than women.
It's very frustrating for them. People might think the person who stammers isn't very articulate. That's not true. Very often they're highly articulate, intelligent people. They just can't express the thoughts that they have. So what have we found out today?
To help your bumpy speaking is to speak slowly.
Oh, well, we're joined now by Children's Schools and Families Minister Ed Balls, who's coped with a lifelong stammer, and Michael Palin, the actor, of course, after whom the Centre and ASIC's report is named. So good to see both of you this morning. I think, Ed, people are going to be very surprised to know that you've had a stammer, because sure. your job involves talking on shows like this and on public speaking, and you don't seem to have a problem.
I think the thing is that sometimes it's very public, but lots of people stammer in a very interiorised way. It's sort of under the surface. And sometimes that can mean that for children and for adults, they just they don't go into public places, they don't speak out because they're worried the words won't come out. But I think the evidence is if you get the right kind of support and if you're calm and you work on being public and dealing with it, then you can deal with it. And it never goes away. It's always there for me. Mm. But at the same time, you know, I can come on TV, Secretary of State, I make my speeches, and I guess what I'm saying today is I can do it. And to the children and the adults watching the programme, you know,
you can get past exactly they can right. get past that problem. Do you remember what it was like being at school and struggling to get those words out?
I do, and back then it just wasn't really talked about. There was no stammering support, and therefore it used to be difficult. But I always thought, look, I want to be a politician, or I want to make speeches, or I want to get on in life, and therefore I'm going to have to deal with it. And it's something which you concentrate on. I think the important thing is to talk about it, ask for help, which wasn't how it was then, but definitely is how it is now. And with Michael's centre in London, which we're hoping now to do a similar centre in the north of England. I was there a couple of years ago with a young woman called Jenny, and she was getting support in the centre. She was aged 15, but for the previous 10 years, she'd had no support because she'd never told anybody. She'd just never spoke in class.
That would be sad.
Finally got the help. Yeah, but now she's at university. She's doing really, really well. And what, you know, the important thing to say to parents is, if you're worried about your child speaking, ask for help.
Yeah.
If your teachers understand, don't interrupt them, let them speak. It's all about confidence and the ability to say, well, you know, I can do it. And
I think sometimes the temptation is to interrupt almost to help the person out because you can see them struggling. And that's not the right thing to do. And Michael, you yourself don't have a stammer, do you? But you did create this incredible part, which we all remember, in A Fish Called Wanda,
exactly,
of a character who had a stammer.
Yeah.
And it was quite comical, and I wonder if that is sometimes perhaps part of there you are in the role there with a very surprised look on your face.
Very surprising haircut.
Yeah, exactly.
That's the worst thing about the part with the haircut.
I mean, I think it is tempting for people to laugh, isn't it? Even though it's far from funny for the person involved.
Yes, it is. And I can remember my father had a very serious stammer, which is how I got involved. Mm. And I can remember being very anxious that people didn't laugh at him. Mm. But of course, amongst children, they do and all that, until you get to know that it's something that you live with. And then it's all right, but it is always a very difficult thing. And I think from my father's point of view, it probably blighted his life, because he was probably not able to do what Ed's done, which is actually address meetings and all that without, because his stammer was really quite serious. So presumably it affected his chances in life. It made him more frustrated. It made him more anxious. It made him more cross. You know, so all these things that he wasn't really. He was actually an intelligent, humorous man.
Now you've become very involved in this centre, haven't you? You've given your name to it. And it seems to affect boys more than girls, men more than women. Do we know why that is?
We don't know why, no.
Interesting,
no,
isn't it?
No, it's interesting, yeah.
Yeah, fascinating. And you, what sort of work are you doing with the youngsters at the centre then?
Well, I'm not doing the work, I must say that. The centre is successful because of the excellent therapists we have there. And we started 17 years ago today, this very day it started, with one therapist. We now have almost a dozen. And what they do is they work with parents, they work with the families. It's not just taking the children and making them learn something by rote, changing it that way. They talk to the parents, try and find out what the situation is, why the child might be under some sort of pressure, and try and relieve that pressure and give the child time to give them some space. And from that, the confidence grows, you become more fluent, and then you feel better, and so it goes on. But so it's very much family-based.
And you would advise people, if they're worried about their youngsters, to go to a centre like yours, and you said there's one opening in the north as well.
Well, we're launching the appeal today. Yeah. Prince Charles is going to be the patron, His Royal Highness, and we're doing it at Clarence House, with the Speaker of the House of Commons coming today, as well as Michael and myself, and we're going to raise the money. We're going to put some money in from the government too, to have a second centre in the north of England, probably Bradford, Leeds. The most important thing to do is to say to people, don't conceal it, don't bury it under the surface. The thing with stammers is, almost all of it is normally happening under the surface.
Yeah.
And, you know, the stammer, the verbal bit, or the pause, or the block, is just what's above the surface. But often people can be in huge turmoil underneath. But all the evidence is, speak up about it, don't hide it. Mm. Just learn to be able to speak and trial and error. But it means everybody else, families, teachers, have got to give people the space to get the confidence. And if you're confident and you're calm and you go through it, you can definitely do it.
And the help is out there. In fact, we have got more help and advice as well when it comes to dealing with stammering and the problems around that on our website, gm.tv. Good to speak to both of you this morning.
Thanks very much.
Thank you.